Hello and welcome to Tech. I am Mohammed Adnan and in this video we are going to discuss about Sync Slicer in Microsoft Power BI. If you are new to this channel, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Sync Slicer, it is released in the yearly version as well, but they have given an improved version of Sync Slicer. We'll discuss from the beginning over the what is the Sync Slicer and what are the additional features which they have added in September 2019. So let's get started. Go to this view tab and in that you have an option like Sync Slicer. Just click on that Sync Slicer. It will open up a window here, and what I will do is I will just click on the before tab and click on the one slicer. So it will give an overview of what are the pages available in this file, and this is for the sync and this is for the visual, it is visible only or not. So this slicer is syncing with not only with this sheet which I have selected now, it also sync with the sum and max sheet, and it is only visible in this sheet, not on the other page as well. What I will do, I will just click on the copy visual, or you can use the Control C and go to this one and paste Control V. So once it is pasted, it will open up a window here. It is asking for one or more of the copied visual can stay in sync with the visual it was copied from. Do you want to keep them in sync? If you click on the sync, it will created here two all tick boxes. Okay, if you make any changes in this selection criteria, say for example I'm just selecting a south here, if you go back to this one, it also filtered here, and also the values also filtered here. If I again change this one to select all, the value is changed, and if I go to this sheet, it also selected. That's the feature of the Sync Slicer, which was the yearly version. And if you want to hide this, say for example, I want to hide this from this one. So what I will do, I will just click on this one, I untick, and if I go back to this one, and go again to this one, so there is no region slicer here. If you notice this, the value is 2.3m, right? So I will just untick all and click on the south again. If you go back to this one, it just filters the value as well. Okay, so I'm selecting it all again and clicking this visual also be visible on this previous page, so it brings up the visual. It brings up the slicer. Okay, so this is the feature of this one, sync, and as well as the visible feature in the sync slicer. Recently they have given one more option here, that is advanced option. Expand this one, it will say that enter a group name to sync selection to any other visual with that group name. So this is region 3. So there are two options here, we'll go one by one now. And if you click on this one, this is also region 3. Okay, sync field changes to other slicer. What does it mean? If I tick this one here, and if I go to this one and also tick this one as well, sync field changes. Okay, so this is the region sort basically. So what I will do is, instead of that, I want to make it to be subcategory instead of region. So I am going to change the instead of region, the subcategory in this field format. So this is changed from region to subcategory here. If we go to this format, it also changed here. Now Control Z. So this is region and this also region. What I will do is, I will just untick this one, sync field changes to other slicer and also to this slicer. Okay, now I want to change this slicer instead of region to be subcategory. So it changed to subcategory. If we go to this one, it is still region because the slicer field has been changed in this shade, and we have untick the option to sync field changes to other slicer with the same group name. Both of the group name is region 3, but if you untick this one, it may not have an effect on the other group, other slicer as well. To make it easier, what I will do is I will just copy this one again and I put it on the same sheet as well. Sync. I will just click on this one and also to this one. I will just change this one to region. So it also changed, right? So if I untick this one, it also unticking here. If I click on this one, it also ticking on this one. Now again, these both of them is region 3. So the field change is also enabled in both of these slicer. Instead of region, I'm going to change it to subcategory. If you click on this, you have a look at this. Both of them has been changed to subcategory. If you untick any of those, it is reflecting on the other side as well. This is the beauty of this one. The next one is sync filter changes to other slicer. As of now, I'm going to tick this in both of them. Filter is basically available in this one, right? The filter options. Oh, I'm just dragging and drop this one. I'm just selecting it all. I'm just selecting the central, so it looks like only the central here. If I select this one, east, south, south and east, it's selecting only the south and east. So what I will do is I will just click on this one and I'm just unticking this one, sync filter changes to other slicer. Click on this and clicking on this. If I click on this one and in the region sort, I'm just adding a central here and also the west. So it is not reflecting in this slicer because we have unticked this one, sync filter changes to other slicer. Just rounding up now. Basically, sync field changes to other slicer means if you change any field, that is, if you change from region to subcategory in one slicer with the same group name. If you enable this option, it will affect on all the slicers. Just in case now, taking it both of them, things will change. Subcategory. So it affect on both of them. Cool. On the other side, sync filter changes to the other slicers. So it is enabled in both of them with the same group name. You go to this one on the filter pane. To click on any of this one, it affect on both of them as well. That is the options given on that. If you untick all those things, it may not have any effect on if we change any of this one. So there is no effect on the other slicer. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you are visiting first time to this channel, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notification directly on your device. But make sure you turn on the notification on your device. Post your comments, queries and feedbacks in the comment section below. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Thanks for watching. Keep learning and see you in the next video.